zyBooks. It's one of the most important learning resources in your MM250 course. So let's take a look at navigating zyBooks and how you'll earn credit for homework in this course. Notice on the homepage, there is a tile to access zyBooks, and I recommend that you start there. So let's click on this link. Notice that all of the unit lab homeworks are listed as zyBooks links, as well as a general link to your zyBook. So we're just gonna link over with the unit one lab homework link and take a look at the first section for unit one. Notice this looks very much like a textbook. And then as you are reading and taking in some of that material, every once in a while, you will come across a participation activity. Here is where you want to interact with the zyBook in order to earn credit for homework. All of the participation activities need to be completed in each chapter. So notice when I click on answers for items in the participation activity, I see immediate feedback for those items. You can see some of them are correct in this instance, some are not. I can use that feedback to edit my answers and get them correct. Also notice there are check marks for each of the responses I currently have correct, but not yet do I see a check mark for this overall participation activity. I need to get this item correct and that participation activity is complete and I can move forward. I move forward, I see some more content and I come across a participation activity that is a learning guide. For these, all you need to do is click the start icon and watch as the example unfolds through this video and press play for each step throughout the video. Follow along with the content. And once you have reviewed that example, notice that participation activity will be marked as completed, as indicated by that check mark in the upper right-hand corner. Now, challenge activities work slightly differently than participation activities. Let's start this one and see what it looks like. Let's just make some sort of selection here and then select check down here at the bottom. Notice it will give me some feedback and then I can retry this by clicking on next. Notice what's happening here is I have an unlimited number of trials to attempt this exercise. And once I get it correct, then I will be able to move on to the next level in this challenge activity. To complete an entire challenge activity, you'll need to complete this level 1, 2, and 3 indicated by these blocks. And notice you will see check marks as you proceed through those correctly for levels 1, 2, and 3, as indicated here. And once all of those are complete, the entire challenge activity will light up as being complete with a check mark here in the upper right-hand corner. Now, beyond the challenge activities and participation activities for the whole section, you will see additional exercises listed at the bottom. These are not required for credit on your homework lab. Beyond all of those additional activities, down at the bottom, you'll see a link to the next section in that chapter. Notice it says 1.2 here. So we click there and come over to section 1.2 and begin to complete that section. If I scroll down to the bottom of this page, I see section 1.3, and I can proceed to section 1.3 once I've completed this section. You want to move through all of those sections for chapter one, completing each of the participation and challenge activities as you see them in the sections for all of those in chapter one. And that corresponds to the lab homework and will be transferred over to your gradebook in Brightspace in our course. Now, you may have noticed at various points along the way, this feedback button right here, like you see it there, you see it in section 1.1 here, and in this participation activity here, if you see what you believe to be an error in the textbook at any point, you are welcome to leave feedback for the publisher. Now, this is not feedback that would go to your instructor. So if you want to highlight something you believe to be in error for them to potentially correct in the textbook, you're welcome to use that feedback option and submit it as you see the options given there. If you have any questions related to the content and want to either get feedback from your instructor or ask a question of your instructor for MM250, then email your instructor directly. That feedback option within the textbook, remember, does not go to your professor. And that is a first look at navigating zyBooks for your lab homework and learning the content for each unit throughout MM250. I hope that you enjoy it and learning the content in this course.